Who is the love one?
Allah.
Who is Ar-Rahman?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah says in the Quran in Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 72, لَكَدْ كَفْرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهُ مُوسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ. They are doing kufr. They are blaspheming those who say that Jesus, the son of Mary, is Allah. وَقَالَ الْمَسِيحِ. But said Christ, Ya Bani Israel, O children of Israel, Ubudullah, worship Allah, Rabbi wa Rabbukum, who's my Lord and your Lord. Innama yushrik billah, anyone who associate partners with Allah, faqad harram Allah alayhi al-jannah. Allah will make jannah haram for him. Wama wahun nar, wama lizalimin ansar, and fire shall be dwelling place, and he shall have no helpers in the hereafter. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says, Ya Bani Israel, Ubudullah, worship Allah, Rabbi wa Rabbukum, my Lord and your Lord. Innama yushrik billah, anyone who associate partners with Allah, faqad haram Allah alayhi al-jannah. Allah will make jannah, paradise, forbidden for him, haram for him. Wama wahun nar, wama lizalimin min ansar, and fire shall be his dwelling place, and he shall have no helpers in the hereafter. The Quran is very clear-cut. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he never claimed divinity. He said, Ubudullah, worship Allah, Rabbi wa Rabbukum, who is my Lord and your Lord. And if you read the Bible, there is not a single unequivocal statement, not a single unambiguous statement anywhere in the Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says, that I am God, already says worship me. If any Christian can point out from anywhere in the Bible any unequivocal statement, any unambiguous statement where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says that I am God, already says worship me, I, Dr. Zakir Naik, I'm ready to accept Christianity today. I am not speaking on behalf of my other Muslim brothers and sisters. I am a student of comparative religion. I have read the Bible. I am ready to put my head on the guillotine. If any Christian points out a single unequivocal statement, a single unambiguous statement from anywhere in the Bible, where Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself says that I am God, or where he says worship me, I today, Dr. Zakir Naik, am ready to accept Christianity. In fact, if you read the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, has clearly mentioned, and in several places, he never claimed divinity. It's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 28. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, my Father is greater than I. Gospel of John, chapter number 10, verse number 29. My Father is greater than all. Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 38. I cast out devil with the spirit of God. Gospel of Luke, chapter number 11, verse number 20. I with the finger of God cast out devil. Gospel of John, chapter number 5, verse number 30. I can of my own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, for I seek not my will, but the will of my Father. Anyone who says, I seek not my will, but the will of Almighty God, he's a Muslim. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, you are the Muslim. He never claimed divinity. In fact, it's clearly mentioned in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 5, verse number 17 to 20, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, think not that I have come to destroy the law of the prophets. I have come not to destroy, but to fulfill. Unless the heavens and the earth pass away, one jot or tittle shall not be passed away until all be fulfilled. And whosoever shall break one of the least commandments and teach men to do so will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. And whosoever shall keep the commandments and teach the same will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. Unless your righteousness exceeds the righteousness of the scribes and the Pharisees, in no way shall you enter the kingdom of heaven. This is a verbatim quotation from the Bible, Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 5, verse number 70 to 20, from the King James Version. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, you have to be better than the Jews to enter Jannah. You have to keep each and every commandment of the Old Testament. If you break one, you shall not enter Jannah. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, he never claimed divinity. In fact, it's clearly mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 24, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, the words that you hear are not mine, but my Father's who has sent me. It's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 17, verse number 3, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, this is life eternal, so that we know there is one God, and Jesus Christ whom thou hast sent. It's further mentioned in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 19, verse number 16 and 17, when a person approaches Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, and asks him, good master, what good things should I do so that I shall achieve eternal life? Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, replies, why thou callest me good? For there is only one good, and that is the Father in heaven. And if you want to enter eternal life, you keep the commandments. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, did not say that if you want to enter Jannah, if you want to go to paradise, you believe that I'm God. He never said, you believe that I died on the cross for your sins. He said, if you want to enter eternal life, you keep the commandments. That means God is one. He has got no images, etc. It's clearly mentioned in the book of Acts, chapter number 2, verse number 22. Ye men of Israel, listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God amongst you by wonders and miracles and signs which God did by him, and you are witness to it. A man approved of God amongst you by wonders and miracles and signs which God did by him, and you are witness to it. And when Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was asked that which is the first of commandment, he repeated verbatim what was said by Moses, peace be upon him, earlier. It's mentioned in the Gospel of Mark, chapter number 12, verse number 29. He said, Shema Israel, Yeru Israel, the Lord, our God, is one Lord. So according to the Bible and according to the Quran, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, never claimed divinity, but he was one of the mightiest messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of Almighty God,